We have reached NFL Week 10. There are 8 games I cannot wait to watch. It's going to be an amazing week of NFL football. Number one, Seattle plays the Packers. The Seahawks quarterback, Russell Wilson, is back from an injury, had a finger injury. We also believe that Aaron Rodgers is going to be back from the Rona. And it should be interesting. Aaron Rodgers, Russell Wilson. The Packers are a better football team. But also, I feel like every time Seattle plays Green Bay, something wacky happens. And unfortunately, the game is Seattle. The wacky stuff appears to have happened in Seattle. So does that weird magic carry over to Green Bay? I don't know. But this will be a good game. I'm excited to watch it. And if Russell Wilson wasn't playing, it would not have been. But because he is, I'm excited to watch that. Game number two, the Bills at the Jets. One reason, and the only reason why this game is interesting, is Mike White, the Jets quarterback. He's making his third ever NFL start. How is Mike White going to play? You got Zach Wilson, the number 2 overall pick from the 2021 NFL draft. He got hurt. Mike White comes in, lights it up. He beats the Bengals, who were a really good football team at the time. They were like 5-2 or something. Can Mike White keep the controversy alive? Can Mike White keep playing well? What happens if Mike White throws for like 350 yards and wins over the Bills on Sunday? What do you do? I want that. That's a storyline I'm rooting for. So Bills-Jets is interesting because of Mike White. If Mike White has a terrible game, I'll talk about it. I'm like, it's noteworthy what happened, but not exciting. Game number three, the Lions at Pittsburgh. The Lions are 0-8. I believe they're going to get their very first win this week on the road in Pittsburgh. The Lions have been close to winning a couple times. I mean, remember, the Lions, they either were tied. I think they actually had the lead over Green Bay. When they played the Packers, they led at halftime. Like, the Lions can compete. They just have a quarterback problem. They have bad luck. The Lions have found a way to lose a game basically every way you can this year. The Lions are better than 0-8. They're not great, but they definitely are better than an 0-8 record. And Pittsburgh has a tendency, because I think it's a cultural issue on the team where they're lackadaisical. They're not as like, they don't get up for bad games. I believe the Lions win in Pittsburgh. I'm calling my shot now. Don't forget that. If I'm right, I want praise. If I'm wrong, I'll be like, I'm an idiot. Every argument you make is that Pittsburgh's going to... It makes sense on paper that Pittsburgh would beat the Lions, but man, I actually don't think so. I really think the Steelers are not as good as I think their record would show, and the Lions are definitely way better than the record would show, and the Lions are hungry, and emotionally... The matchup here is a hungry Lions team against a Pittsburgh team that tends to not show up when there's nothing expected of them. So I believe the Lions win in Pittsburgh. Number four, the Falcons at the Cowboys. Dan Quinn, the Cowboys defensive coordinator, used to be the head coach in Atlanta. So it's him against his former team, plus Dallas is coming off of a really bad loss to Denver. They were losing 30-0 with 6 minutes left against Denver. I believe the Cowboys win big over Atlanta at home. Number five, the Browns at the Patriots. Both teams are 5-4. The Patriots and the Browns are both fighting to get into the playoffs. You have Mac Jones playing better and better every week. Baker Mayfield lost OBJ. It seems like without OBJ, Baker Mayfield's a better quarterback somehow. I have no idea what to expect. And that's kind of why this is a great game. It's a good matchup that is unpredictable, and maybe the Patriots win with a blowout. Maybe the Browns blow out the Patriots. I think what it's going to happen is going to be a really close, fun game that is unpredictable, and that's exactly the kind of game I want to watch. I hate when I know going into a game, one team is going to dominate the other, and I have no idea what's going to happen with Patriots and Browns. Number six, the Eagles at the Denver Broncos. Denver got my attention last week. Remember, they led Dallas 30-0 with 6 minutes left in that football game. Was it a fluke? Is Denver a one-hit wonder? Do they have a great game? Or are they actually a good football team that's making progress? We will find out in Denver against Philly on Sunday. Number seven, Sunday Night Football, the Chiefs at the Raiders. The Raiders have been through a lot of off-the-field stuff this year. Stuff that it's hard to overcome. Your coach gets fired. One of your teammates kills someone. Another guy threatens people with weapons. It's just a terrible, horrible thing. A series of events that have gone on with the Raiders and their organization. I don't think they're going to overcome that. Their slide, I think, has already begun. They lost last week. I think it's going to continue to happen. But meanwhile, Kansas City is their own kind of mess on the field. And so got one messy team against another messy team, a bunch of unknowns. That equation all leads to a very, very interesting game on Sunday Night Football. I am crossing my fingers, hoping it'll be close, competitive, and interesting, and keep your eye on Kansas City at the Raiders on Sunday. Monday Night Football, game number 8, the Rams at the 49ers. Here's the question. Will the Rams win, or will they blow out the 49ers? Like, will they just win, or will they win by like 30 points? Because I worry that 49ers coach Kyle Shanahan is actually going to get fired. He could actually get fired after this year. I'm like, the 49ers look bad every week. And first of all, it's our first opportunity to see Von Miller in a Rams jersey. That'll be fun. I doubt Odell Beckham Jr. is going to play for the Rams this week, but he might. We'll find out. But again, I would be absolutely shocked if the Rams lost this game to the 49ers on Sunday. They got Von Miller. They got momentum. They're excited. There's a lot of energy in that organization. And I mean, Kyle Shanahan could use a win here over a really good Rams team on Monday night.